trials. Those things that, much like marriage, are pretty awkward when a key participant doesn't show up. Although, I think you can plead insanity in both cases. So, why are we talking about trials on this episode of Thai Thursday? Well, because these days Thailand is losing politicians faster than a soy cowboy bar at closing time, with more fugitive politicians leaving every day. That's why Thailand recently passed a law saying that, when it comes to a politician's trial, if that politician is a fugitive, they don't have to show up. What a nice way to accommodate your on-the-go politicians who are too busy to show up to their own corruption charge hearings. Today, we're talking about the trial of ex-Prime Minister Thaksin Shinawatra, because he was unable to show up to his trial. Now, this case was supposed to have taken place in 2008, but was delayed after Thaksin Shinawatra fled the country, because not even Clint Eastwood can make interrogating an empty chair look cool.
How do you handle promises that you made when you were running for election, and how do you handle it? I mean, what do you say to people?
This case is currently being dealt with by the Thai Supreme Court Criminal Division for Political Officeholders. And let me tell you, it is never a good sign for your country when you have a designated division dedicated to criminal charges for political officeholders. It's taking place now because recently a new law was passed saying that trials can proceed in absentia against politicians in situations where cases have been suspended because the defendants have fled the country. Now, some would say this makes sense, unless of course the courts are using these cases for political purposes to ensure that exiled politicians have enormous rap sheets, ensuring that activists and politicians cannot return to that country. For example, the subject of this court case currently has 6 warrants out for his arrest, not including the one we're talking about now or the 3 new cases that are about to go through. So yeah, he's not coming back to Thailand anytime soon. So let's get into this law a little more because it's pretty interesting. You see, Thai courts usually adopt an accusatory legal system, like the legal system in the US, where someone accuses someone else of doing something and then they have to prove that person actually did it in court. But Deputy Prime Minister Wisanu said, "You can't help it, the court adopts an inquisitorial system." The system is one where, rather than being an impartial referee, the court's acting more as the prosecutor's hype man, and actively participating in the evidence-gathering effort. Now, in this case against Thaksin, the ex-prime minister elected not to have his legal defense show up to court, so a public defender was appointed. And let me tell you, when the justice system that's trying to charge you for something comes in to look for your lawyer, oh man, do they go to the bargain bins. I'm not even sure this is a Craigslist level of bargain. We're talking Backpage. So, the trial happened. Well, his absence was interpreted as a denial of the charges, which is weird because generally fleeing the country is probably more of a sign that you've accepted the charges. Now, in a conclusion about as surprising as sex in a porno, he has lost the case, although he couldn't be arrested considering that he was out of the country. Now, copies of his arrest warrant have been posted outside of his house in Bangkok, just in case he was visiting and didn't get the news. It also ordered a public prosecutor to seek his arrest and give monthly reports, which will probably read kind of like a travel blog. This month, Thaksin was spotted in Singapore with his family, and last month, oh, here's a picture of him in Dubai. So, what's the real threat here? I mean, it seems kind of funny that a country with a king who might have fewer extradition powers than the Burger King is handing out arrest warrants for people outside the country. But there are some unique positives and negatives to this situation. Now, first we have the positive to those cases without defendants present. While some people think that this is all a political stunt, Thaksin was charged with wrongfully changing regulations on telecom concession fees in favor of companies he owned, causing a loss to the state of 68 billion baht while prime minister. So yeah, this case isn't determining whether he was loyal to the crown or government, but rather whether he illegally amended telecommunications taxation to benefit himself. In the US and most of the EU, just the member countries people actually want to visit, this trial by absentia is illegal. Although, for those of you in the US who are planning on leaving a sentencing because, loophole. Just know that if you show up for trial, you can still be later hit by a trial by absentia if you stop showing up. A second thing is, without showing up to court himself, he could have hired legal counsel to represent him or someone to get tried in his place. Just do anything to make the prosecution feel less lonely. But he refused to send any representation. So the real threat here is that, first, these types of trials are being used to keep activists out of the country. Thaksin Shinawatra, from 2001 to 2005, was the first democratically elected Thai prime minister to serve out his entire term. You see, generally in Thailand, the military functions like a vaudeville hook. Just dragging politicians off the stage. That is, until 2014, when they decided to start their own act. Anyways, Prime Minister Shinawatra actually managed to last one entire term, until the military took him out midway through his second. He is an outspoken pro-democracy advocate who, as you can probably imagine, is not the biggest fan of the military junta. If that name sounds familiar, it's because he's the brother to the last democratically elected Prime Minister of Thailand, Yingluck. If he ever steps foot in Thailand again, he's not going to step foot in any other country for a long time. A similar 5-year sentence was just given to Prime Minister Yingluck in her absence as well. If these trials are being targeted to certain parties or interests to keep them out of the country, that could really solidify the Thai junta's power in the region, at a time when some people seem to kind of want an election. Thaksin's lawyer said, "This law has a retroactive effect, which is against international legal principles. We oppose all forms of injustice. Although, it might have had more impact if he actually had anything to do with this case." Now, this accusation is that the Thai government can pick and choose which politicians they want to charge with crimes retrospectively. And, under the seemingly correct assumption that all politicians have committed crimes, would mean that they can dictate who legislates and who stays away. Show me a politician with a clean rap sheet and I will show you his election-winning opponent. The other problem with these cases is an inherent injustice in that absentia trial system. When Cambodia tried to include trials by absentia in their constitution, Amnesty International said, "Trials in absentia compromise the ability of an accused to exercise his or her rights under Article 14 of the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights." And, as you can probably imagine, that influenced the Cambodian government about as much as learning that for $3 a week they could protect a sequoia tree in California. But it does raise an interesting ethical point that these international treaties demand the right to be present during the trial, the right to defend his or herself through counsel of choice, and the right to examine a witness. I'm not making this up. In these Thai trials of absentia, sometimes the judge is actually forced to cross-examine the witnesses. And I still have trouble wrapping my mind around how a judge who needs to remain impartial can cross-examine someone. "According to your testimony, you said you were home at 8 o'clock, correct?" "Oh, okay, thank you, just checking." Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hey YouTube, I have a LINE account and my ID is Person of Interest 101 and my QR code is right here. So feel free to reach out with me if you have any suggestions for future episodes. Make sure you remember to subscribe by clicking here and checking out some of our previous episodes of Thai Thursday by clicking here. And remember to like below. And if you're really a fan, you can just go over and check out our That's All I Have to Say About That Facebook group. Thank you for watching.